Hello children, welcome to online class. I hope you are safe and good. Children, in the last class we were discussing about the 17 oranges, unit 4, is it? Yes. So you all remember the story? The narrator used to work at the shipyard carrying shipmates to docks, and he had an intense love for oranges. He stole them from the boats and ships and chipped them for us. However, once he was caught by the security police guard, Pongo. Pongo wanted to make his case an example for all the other workers and frighten them for the consequences of dishonesty and stealing. So he locked the narrator up in the room. So I hope you have remembered this story. So let's see what happens now. So in the last class we discussed that he was locked in his cabin with the 17 oranges. Let's see how he is able to escape from the cabin. Okay. Let us see how whether he has proved dishonest or honest now. I hope I have stopped from this. Okay, let me start from this. Too many people are stealing from the dogs, Pongo said. You have stolen these oranges and concealed them in your pocket. Have you anything to say? So now the Pongo is saying, too many people. So many people are stealing from the dogs, Pongo said, and you have stolen these 17 oranges. And do you have, this is the act of keeping something secret. He has hid the oranges in the pocket. Is it, this is the way you will hide this? This is the way you steal. So have you anything to say? Do you have anything to say? Now the Pongo is questioning. So he is questioning that this is the way you steal the things from the dogs, and do you have anything to say? Who is asking? Pongo. Let's see what his narrator is saying. I said nothing. I was very frightened, but I kept quiet. I had read a lot of detective stories to make the mistake of blabbing. Anything you say may be used as evidence against you. I knew that the best plan was to say nothing. So he didn't say anything. He was very frightened and he kept quiet. So actually, children, our narrator has read a lot of detective stories to make the mistake. Actually, some people know blabbing. I told you, they'll say something with the tense, with the unconsciousness. They'll blabble something. They will speak out something. So he don't want to do that mistake by blabbling, and he kept completely quiet. Anything you say may be used as the evidence against you. So if he say anything, it can be used as the evidence. So he kept himself very quiet. I knew that the best plan was to say nothing. So the best way to keep himself quiet. So you won't say anything, said Pongo. I am going to bring another policeman here. He will be witness against you when I bring up this case in the court. So you are not going to open your mouth and you are not going to say anything. Okay, let me go and bring another policeman here, and he will be witness against you, and this case I'll bring in the court now. So he has went to bring the another policeman. So now, what will my father do? I almost gave up the hope of escaping from the trouble. I was locked in the cabin and the oranges were on the table. Pongo had gone to bring a witness. I was in trouble. So now he was thinking, my father is there, what he will be doing it? So he was completely, he was given away. He was completely gave up the hope of escaping from this trouble. And he was locked in the cabin and the oranges were on the table. So Pongo had gone to bring the witness now. He has gone to bring another policeman now, a witness, and he was in complete terrible. Okay, he was completely in trouble. Oh my God, I said, what can I do? Eat the oranges, said a voice in my head. Eat the evidence. So now from his inner voice, will say, Noma, he is saying that eat the oranges, eat the evidence, eat them. I asked. So he is asking himself, eat them. I asked. Yes, said the voice in my head. Eat them and the evidence will be gone. Be quick, eat them all. So now he is getting a voice that, yes, said the voice in my head that eat them, eat the oranges. When you eat the oranges, evidence will be gone. So be quick and eat them all. Let's see what our narrator is doing. Actually, children, if it is apple, we'll be able to eat. I said, we'll not worry about it, we'll be able to eat. Oranges, you all know how so taste it will become. It is actually so, when compared to so, it is bitter taste. Is it? So I thought for half a second, only half a second he thought. Then I took an orange, I peeled it and put it in my mouth. Soon only the peeps were left. So immediately he peeled it, he peeled the oranges and he put it in his mouth. So only the peeps were left. So do you know? We'll discuss now. One orange contained one daily requirement of vitamin C. Oranges were first grown in India and then they spread to the other parts of the world. So oranges were first found in the India. Yes, you have swallowed the peeps too, said the voice in my head. You have to swallow the peeps and the peel. You have to swallow all the evidence. So from the inner voice, once again the voice from the head is saying that you have to, not only the fruit, you are supposed to swallow the peeps and peel. So how is it possible, dear? It is really impossible, is it? But let's see what our narrator is doing. Yes, of course, I said, I swallow the peeps and put some of the peel in my mouth. Don't eat it, said the voice. There isn't time. Swallow it. Be quick. Swallow it. So now again the inner voice is saying you don't have time to chew and eat. Just swallow. Okay. So let's see what he's doing. I took a small knife from my pocket and cut the oranges into large chunks. I swallowed the pieces of orange one after the other. So he used to have a small knife in his pocket and he cut the oranges into large chunks. Already we have discussed, no children, meaning of chunk is thick large piece of something. So he has cut into a thick large pieces and he swallowed the pieces of oranges one after another because he had no time. At any moment the police along with the witness, he'll come. Pongo can come along with the witness. So he was going on swallowing the orange fruit along with the peeps and peels. Yes, there were still three oranges on the table when I heard Pongo outside. I stopped. My stomach was nearly full. So actually still there were three oranges on the table when I heard the Pongo outside and he stopped. And almost his stomach was also full. So 17 oranges at this stage within a few minutes, now how it is possible, is it? So be quick. Swallow them, said the voice in my head. Again the voice from the head is saying, be quick, swallow them, quickly, do it. I was lucky. Pongo and the other policeman had seen some caught at the dog gate. They went and talked to the drivers. This gave me a few more minutes. So actually that on that day the narrator was also lucky, and this Pongo along with the witness, another policeman, they saw some drivers. They saw some cots at the docks, and they went there to talk with them. So he got few more minutes, and from that he utilized that few more minutes. I must swallow all the oranges, I thought. Only three left. I swallowed the first one and then the second one. Suddenly the door began to open. I went through a great deal of struggle and finally managed to finish off the last peel of the last orange. So anyhow, he has when there were three oranges left on the table, his stomach was full, but he managed to eat one, two, along with the peels and peeps, and finally it was the last one, that last piece of orange also he was able to manage. He was swallowed everything. Pongo and the other policeman walked in. This is the thief, Pongo said. I caught him with his pocket full of oranges. So now the Pongo is saying, this is the thief and I caught him with his pocket full of oranges. Then Pongo looked at the table and at first he could not figure out what had happened. Where are the oranges? I can smell them, said the other policeman. So now the Pongo, he looked at the table at first, and he is not able to figure himself, he is not able to figure out himself, he is not able to recognize the situation, what might have happened. So he is asking, where are the oranges? And the other policeman can smell the, because aroma of oranges are very heavy, is it? Yes. So his other policeman is able to smell the oranges, and here is not, Pongo is not able to find out what might have happened. He is not able to figure out this situation now. Let's see what is happening. Giving oranges during their New Year season is a festive ritual of the Chinese. They are usually given in pairs as a symbol of friendship. Yes. Okay, so as a symbol of friendship in the China, they used to give the pair of oranges. Okay, ma. I said nothing, so he has not opened the mouth now also. Pongo looked everywhere for the oranges. He looked in my pocket, he looked in my apron, but he didn't find one orange. Finally, Pongo understood what had happened, but it was very difficult to believe. So Pongo, he looked everywhere, he looked in the pocket, he looked at the apron, but he is not able to find the oranges. But finally, policeman is able to identify what might have happened. 17 oranges, he said. 17 big oranges. How did you eat them all? So now policeman is asking, 17 oranges, 17 big oranges. How did you eat all these oranges? Again, he didn't say anything. I said nothing. Pongo was not able to send me to prison. There was no evidence. So now the Pongo is not able to send him to the prison, send the narrator to prison. Why? Because he has no evidence. Pongo became angry and shouted at me, but I didn't say a word. So now he has come to the hyper and he was very angry and shouted at the narrator. But the narrator didn't say even a single word. In the end, he had to let me go. So finally, at last, he had to let him go. Actually, children, so see now, we all know the proverb that too much of anything is good for nothing. So let's see what is happening with the narrator, because he has eaten too much of oranges. Yes, I told Clem Jones about the 17 oranges. Pongo locked you in that cabin for half an hour, said Clem. He had no right to do that. Perhaps Clem was right. I don't know. I didn't have time to think about it. So when he said this about the 17 oranges to Clem Jones, and now the Pongo was Pongo actually Pongo locked you. So now the Clem is saying that Pongo had locked you in the cabin for an hour, and he has no right to do that. So actually, that policeman, he doesn't have a right to lock this man in the cabin, but he has done for half an hour. So actually, he is very good in talking, is it? So he has said like that. Perhaps Clem was right. I don't know. I didn't have time to think about it. He didn't have that much sense to think about it. I had eaten 17 large oranges. So he has eaten 17 large oranges along with the peels and peep and all. Okay, peeps and all. I felt very sick for a week, and those oranges kept working away in my stomach. And he was very upset for, his stomach was very upset for a week. He was felt sick for a week, and those oranges were working away in his stomach. So I hope, children, you have understood the story. Is it what had happened? Yes, when the police officer locked him in a room and went out for getting another police officer to be a witness, the narrator, what did he do? He ate up all the 17 oranges with the seeds and peel and vanished the last of the evidence against him. Actually, that was a bitter experience for the narrator. Well, thereafter, he was never crazy about the oranges. Okay, children, the moral of the story is, never be obsessed. Actually, never be very interested with things you like, children. You okay? Never be very interested with the things you like the most. Why? Because when someone is truly obsessed, their interest has become compulsive and they might have begun to lose control over it. So never be very interested about the things you like the most. I hope children you have liked this lesson. You might have enjoyed with this lesson. Yes, question answers will be sent through PDF. Complete your classwork and submit your classwork at office room. Thank you children. Meet you again with the next lesson. Okay. Take care.